that last note in post, Ruby. Technology rules, doesn't it? Hi there. I'm Peter Kieswalter from the East Village Opera Company, and we are thrilled about our Grammy nomination for Best Classical Crossover Record, but a little bit perplexed as to the amount of media attention that this most prestigious honor has brought our way. Where were you when you heard? How do you feel? What will you wear to the show? What is classical crossover? So on, so on. It's all been a little bit nutty. And now that our album, Olde School, that's old with an E, now that the album has come under such intense media scrutiny, I feel the need to come clean as to the making of it. You see, classical crossover records and classical records in general are made with very small budgets, due to the fact that they can be tossed off and mixed within a few hours. Our record took well over a year to make, and the fact is, we were rarely around to participate in the actual making of this record. Our label would never have allowed us to make this record had they known who was actually in charge and how it was that we actually made this. We used what we in the industry called a ghost producer. That's someone who does all of the work but receives none of the credit, and in this case, none of the money. Technology is a beast that's being mastered and tamed by younger and younger kids all the time. You know that story about how Mozart could not even reach the piano pedals when he wrote his first symphony? Well, our producer still wears a pull-up to bed. Check this out. Meet 3-year-old Ruby Kay. She loves the studio. She loves her bears.
Hi, new bear.
She might not have the best technique, but she knows it's not what you play, it's how you edit. She puts everyone in the studio at ease.
Hi, everybody. I'm here to save the day.
Save the day, indeed, and save the project. Armed with her vintage 1980s Mac computer, she claims it sounds better. A cracked copy of Pro Tools Ultralight, a tiny synth, a few shakers and rattles, and a work ethic that belies her tender age, she is unfailingly modest and quick to deflect and share the credit of her rapidly spreading reputation.
So it seems like a lot of the credit for this record should go to Ruby K instead of EVOC.
Ruby K? You could call yourself Ruby K.
Seems like those prenatal guitar lessons have paid off for this modern-day wunderkind. Along with the firm grasp of alternate tunings that render fretting obsolete. She's no Eddie Van Halen, but like they say, good enough for classical crossover. You can kid her about working so hard in a marginal genre whose name carries the stigma of processed cheese. But don't kid her about her musical influences. When asked, she won't say. But she will coyly play a few bars.
What's that song?
What's that song? Well, it doesn't take a Harvard musical theater professor to name that song, or Sherlock Holmes to reveal the source of her inspiration. Just check out her record collection.
Do you think this song needs more work? So then, should we fix it in the computer?
Then